welcome to the second annual Fine Arts Winter Showcase. We have a wonderful program lined up for you. My name is Gina Herjani, and I will be the MC for the evening. I hope you were able to enjoy the amazing artwork displayed by our visual arts students in the hallway and front lobby. Miss Alice Fisher does a wonderful job with her students, and we are so fortunate to have her here at GP. Our hope is that as you listen tonight, you are able to sit back and enjoy the music of the season. Hopefully, you'll recognize some of your favorite songs being sung or played, and with coffee or hot chocolate in hand, you will be able to relax and sing along, if you wish. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please welcome the Junior High Band as they play Carol of the Bells.
Thank you. Thank you. Terribly, horribly cold out there.
You want some hot tea?
No, I just want to take these shoes off.
We've got to get you a new pair. Those aren't great fit.
Well, I really don't like spending money I don't have, hence the newspaper. Plus, it does keep my feet dry.
And they say the newsprint is dying.
Well, either way, let's just sit back, relax, and watch some TV.
No, I can't. I've got dog walking appointments. Call in the Bichon Frise.
Yeah, what is a, Bichon Frise?
It's like an angry, neurotic collie pup.
Okay. Well, I'll be here whenever you get back.
Good. Go for a treat.
Sure.
And maybe find a tiny little angel to go on top. Nothing too big. What time is it? I've got to get ready.
Well, according to my great-grandfather's pocket watch, which, by the way, has been still ticking after 8 years.
You've got to get a new watch, Bob. You're going to lose it.
Boots. Bobs. Tiny, misshapen angels. What else do we need? What is that?
Hey, it's not like I can afford that absolutely gorgeous comb and clip set at Macy's. It's gold-plated and it's made special to go easy on your follicles.
Well, I do think you deserve it.
I do. And you deserve your shoes.
True. I guess we are really shortchanged.
Gotta go. Love ya.
Thank you.
was about to go do some Christmas shopping. What's up?
Well, we've all got to pitch in a little bit of money for the big boss's Christmas gift.
Oh! So, funny you mentioned that. I'm short on money.
Ah! Can't you see those cameras all over this place?
Is that to tell how much we put in the box?
Yeah. Well, remember Fred from the loaded dog?
Bah.
Well, last year he gave $7.50.
I haven't seen Fred in a really long time.
Yeah, well, no one has. Mm-hmm. One day, Fred was just gone.
Okay, well, in that case, here's some money. Here's some more money.
Awesome, Jimbo. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas!
Thank you.
clubs that are private on. It's not really a combo that you see go together often, but it's whatever. In the wild, I'm pretty sure they're like natural enemies or something, but it just makes no sense.
Yeah, I'm realizing a lot of things don't make sense anymore.
Yeah, for sure. Like the holidays. It's a tough time. Speaking of time, you really gotta get a new watch pocket before you lose it. You know that thing's valuable.
It is valuable, and it is 7:30 on the dot.
Okay, gotta go.
Love you too.
Okay, thank you, Bella. Judging by prices, we only have enough money for one shoe. And I have exactly, $12. Well, I don't know what I'm going to do with that. I made up that great pep story, and I can't afford anything. What am I going to do?
Hey! Did I hear you say you need some quick cash?
Maybe.
Here's a car.
Okay.
She buys hair. They do extensions, all kinds of stuff.
I mean, my parents are curious, but I don't know if it's going to be enough.
You got both kidneys?
Let's go. Hi. I hear you buy hair.
Jack of all trades. Come on in.
How long is this going to take? I have to go buy my husband a Christmas present, and I don't have to my friends.
Doing it for a man, huh? Terrific mistake. I'm on my sixth husband. It's all fun and games till you settle down. Then everybody gets miserable.
How much can you give me?
Dada.
I don't know if my hair is going to be enough.
I'm on my third husband. I'm on my third husband. That's what I thought about my third husband. He moved me to Louisiana, and I had to escape through a swamp. Now, half of my left foot is in a gator's belly.
How much can you give me?
Final offer.
I don't know if that's a good
idea. Nah, but I got lots of merchandise in the back. How do you like a hammer? I'll engrave his name on it. Throw in some nails. I got a rabbit-hide wallet.
How much is a watch fall?
I think you got just enough.
Shopping. Actually, I got you this.
When did you see what I got you?
What is that on your head?
Oh, this? I just got a little haircut. It's no biggie. Never mind that.
How much cut?
All of it. But I can feel it growing back already.
Why?
So I can buy you this.
So, funny thing. I sold my pocket watch to buy you this.
It's beautiful, but now you don't have a watch on phone!
Hey, listen, it's okay. We have each other, and that's all we need.
Merry Christmas, Jeff.
Merry Christmas.
Economics isn't happiness. It depends on who is doing the counting and who's doing the money. Those who know how to give and receive during this holiday season are the ones who were wise, like the Magi of old.
Thank you.
As everyone is joining us on stage for our final number, I'd like to introduce our wonderful tech crew up in the sound booth. Aya Moyani is running the music and soundboard. Catherine Banks is running the light board, and Kaylee Sierra is in charge of the spotlight. Let's give them a hand to show our appreciation for the special effects they brought to the show. Finally, I'd like to recognize the directors of the group this evening. Ms. Mariah Waller is new to GP this year and has done a great job with the band, along with Mr. Mark Harrell, as you saw tonight. Ms. Bobby Watson is our choral director and loves putting on programs like these that bring our community together. At this time, we are set up and ready for our final song. Please enjoy.
Thank you guys for coming, and we do hope that you have a very Merry Christmas. Good night.